Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. You'll have seen from your programme I pop up later, but I wanted to welcome you and to say how fantastic it is to be able to hold this event live and in person. You can imagine the conversations we've had within the school and with Mrs. Jashari about whether or not we can go ahead this evening. And I hope you'll excuse me if I say that I thought that I'd rather make the decision myself than listen to what Boris had to say, just at the moment. But we did feel it was really important to do everything possible to go ahead and hold this event with parents in the audience, even if it is only one parent permitted from each family of the children who are performing. So without further ado, I will hand you over to Mrs. Jashari and the musicians so that we can have a magical evening of Christmas and words of music. When we have our choral, what are they called? That's it, carols, thank you. When we have the carols, we just stand when the take our lead from the choir and we'll follow them and enjoy our singing too. Thank you.
In the Beginning by Dylan Thomas. In the beginning was the three-pointed star, one smile of light across the empty face, one bow of bone across the rooting air, the substance forked that marrowed the first sun, and burning ciphers on the round of space, heaven and hell mixed as they spun.
In the beginning was a pale signature, three-syllabled and starry as the smile. And after came the imprints on the water, stamp of the minted face upon the moon, the blood that touched the cross tree and the grail, touched the first cloud and left a sign.
In the beginning was the mounting fire that set alight the weathers from a spark, a three-eyed, red-eyed spark, blunt as a flower, life rose and spouted from the rolling seas, burst in the roots, pumped from the earth and rock the secret oils that drive the grass.
In the beginning was the Word that from the solid bases of the light abstracted all the letters of the void, and from the cloudy bases of the breath, the Word followed up, translating to the heart, first characters of birth and death.
In the beginning was the secret brain. The brain was celled and soldered in the thought, before the pitch was forking to a sun.
Before the veins were shaking in their sieve, blotched and shattered to the winds of light, and the ribbed love of love.
Ooh. This is Snow in Bethlehem by Maya Angelou. Thunder rumbles in the mountain passes, and lightning rattles the eaves of our houses. Floodwaters await us in our avenues. Snow falls upon snow, falls upon snow, to avalanche over unprotected villages. The sky slips low and grey and threatening. We question ourselves. What have we done to so affront our nature? We worry, God, are you there? Are you there, really? Does the covenant you made with us still hold? Into this climate of fear and apprehension, Christmas enters. Hope is born again in the faces of children. It rides on the shoulders of our aged as they walk into their sunsets. Hope spreads around the earth, brightening all things, even hate which crouches, breeding in corridors. In our joy, we think we hear a whisper. At first, it is too soft, they only half heard. We listen carefully as it gathers strength. We hear a sweetness. The word is peace. We shout with glorious tongues the coming of hope. All the earth's tribes loosen their voices to celebrate the promise of peace. We, angels and mortals, believers and non-believers, look heavenward and speak the word aloud. Peace. We look at each other, then into ourselves, and we say, without shyness or apology or hesitation, peace, my brother. Peace, my sister. Peace, my soul.
Thank you. Visit from St. Nicholas
by Clement Clark Moore.
'Twas the night before Christmas when all through the house not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse.
The stockings were hung by the chimney with care, in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there.
The children were nestled all snug in their beds, while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads.
And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap.
When out on the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter.
Away to the window I flew like a flash, tore open the shutters and threw up the sash.
The moon on the breast of the new fallen snow gave the lustre of midday to objects below.
When what to my wondering eyes should appear but a miniature sleigh and 8 tiny reindeer. With a little old driver so lively and quick,
I knew in a moment it must be St. Nick. More rapid than eagles his coursers they came, and he whistled and shouted and called them by name.
Now Dasher, now Dancer, now Prancer and Vixen, on Comet, on Cupid, on Donder and Blitzen.
To the top of the porch,
to the top of the wall,
now dash away,
dash away, dash away all.
As dry leaves that before the wild hurricane fly, when they meet with an obstacle, mount to the sky.
So up to the housetop the coursers they flew, with the sleigh full of toys, and St. Nicholas too.
And then in a twinkling I heard on the roof the prancing and pawing of each little hoof.
As I drew my head and was turning around, down the chimney St. Nicholas came with a bound.
He was dressed all in fur from his head to his foot, and his clothes were all tarnished with ashes and soot. A bundle of toys he had flung on his back, and he looked like a peddler just opening his pack.
His eyes, how they twinkled.
His dimples, how merry.
His cheeks were like roses.
His nose like a cherry. The beard of his
chin was, his droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow.
And the beard of his chin was as white as the snow. The stump of a pipe he held tight in his teeth, and the smoke, it encircled his head like a wreath.
He had a broad face and a little round belly that shook when he laughed, like a bowl full of jelly.
He was chubby and plump, a right jolly old elf, and I laughed when I saw him in spite of myself.
A wink of his eye and a twist of his head soon gave me to know I had nothing to dread.
He spoke not a word, but went straight to his work and filled up all the stockings, then turned with a jerk.
And laying his finger aside of his nose and giving a nod, up the chimney he rose.
He sprang to his sleigh, so his team gave a whistle, and away they all flew like the down of a thistle.
But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight,
"Happy Christmas to all! Ho, ho, ho! And to all a good night!"
Thank you. from Harry Potter and the Philosopher's Stone by J.K. Rowling.
Harry had never in all his life had such a Christmas dinner. 100 fat roast turkeys, mountains of roast and boiled potatoes, platters of chipolatas, tureens of buttered peas, silver boats of thick, rich gravy and cranberry sauce, and stacks of wizard crackers every few feet along the table. These fantastic party favours were nothing like the feeble muggle ones the Dursleys usually bought, with their little plastic toys and their flimsy paper hats inside.
Harry pulled a wizard cracker with Fred, and it didn't just bang, it went off with a blast like a cannon and engulfed them all in a cloud of blue smoke, while from the inside exploded a Rear Admiral's hat and several live white mice. Up at the high table, Dumbledore had swapped his pointed wizard hat for a flowered bonnet, and he was chuckling merrily at a joke Professor Flitwick had just read for him.
Flaming Christmas puddings followed the turkey. Percy nearly broke his teeth on the silver sickle embedded in his slice. Harry watched Hagrid getting redder and redder in the face as he called for more wine, finally kissing Professor McGonagall on the cheek, who, to Harry's amazement, giggled and blushed, her top hat lopsided.
When Harry finally left the table, he was laden down with a stack of things out of the crackers, including a pack of non-explodable, luminous balloons, a grow-your-own-warts kit, and his new wizard chess set. The white mice had disappeared, and Harry had a nasty feeling they were going to end up as Mrs. Norris's Christmas dinner.
Harry and the Weasleys spent a happy afternoon having a furious snowball fight on the grounds. Then cold, wet, and gasping for breath, they returned to the fire in the Gryffindor common room, where Harry broke in his new chess set by losing spectacularly to Ron. He expected he wouldn't have lost so badly if Percy hadn't tried to help him so much.
After a meal of turkey sandwiches, crumpets, trifle and Christmas cake, everyone felt too full and sleepy to do much before bed, except sit and watch Percy chase Fred and George all over Gryffindor Tower because they'd stolen his prefect badge.
It had been Harry's best Christmas day ever.
Thank you. Noel, Christmas Eve 1913, by Robert Bridges. A frosty Christmas Eve, when the stars were shining, fared I forth alone, where westward falls the hill, and from many a village in the watered valley, distant music reached me. Peals of bells are ringing, the constellated sounds ran sprinkling on earth's floor, as the dark vault above with stars was spangled o'er.
Then sped my thoughts to keep that first Christmas of all, when the shepherds watching by their folds o'er the dawn, heard music in the fields and marvelling could not tell whether it were the angels or the bright stars singing.
Now blessed be the towers that crown England so fair, that stand up strong in prayer unto God for our souls. Blessed be their founders, said I, and our country folk, who are ringing for Christ in the belfries tonight, with arms lifted to clutch the rustling ropes that race into the dark above and the mad romping din.
But to me, heard afar, it was starry music, angels' song, comforting as the comfort of Christ, when he spoke tenderly to his sorrowful flock,
The old words came to me by the riches of time, mellowed and transfigured, as I stood on the hill, hearkening in the aspect of thy eternal silence.
Thank you. Thank you. Matthew chapter 2, verses 1 to 11. Now, when Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, in the days of Herod the king, behold, there came wise men from the east to Jerusalem, saying, "Where is he that is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east, and are come to worship him." When Herod the king had heard these things, he was troubled, and all Jerusalem with him. And when he gathered all the chief priests and scribes for people together, he demanded of them where Christ would be born. And they said unto him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for thus it is written by the prophet, 'And thou, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, art not the least among the princes of Judah, for out of thee shall come a governor that shall rule my people Israel.'" Then Herod, when he had privily called the wise men, inquired of them diligently what time the star appeared. And he sent them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for the young child. And when ye have found him, bring me word again, that I may come and worship him also." And when they heard the king, they departed. And lo, the star, which they saw in the east, went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. When they saw the star, they rejoiced with exceeding great joy. And when they were come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they opened their treasures, they presented unto him gifts, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you. At nine of the night, by Charles Causley. At nine of the night, I open my door that stands midway between moor and moor, and all around me, silver bright, I saw that the world had turned to white.
Thick was the snow on field and hedge, and vanished was the river sedge, where winter skillfully had wound a shining scarf without a sound.
And as I stood and gazed my fill, a shepherd boy came down the hill. With every step I saw him take, flew at his heel a silver flake.
His brow was whiter than the hoar, a beard of freshest snow he wore, and round about him snowflakes starred, a red horse blanket from the yard.
In his red cloak I saw him go. His back was bent, his step was slow, and as he laboured through the cold, he seemed 100 winters old.
I stood and watched his snowy head, their whiskers white, a cloak of red. A Merry Christmas, I heard him cry. The same to you, old friend, said I.
Ba-boom, 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 ba-boom.
Santa baby, just slip the sable under the tree for me.
Ba-boom,
been an awful good girl. Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight.
Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do-
light blue. I'll wait up for you, dear Santa baby. So hurry down the chimney tonight. Think of all the fun I miss. Think of all the fellas that I haven't kissed. Next year I'd do just as good if you check off my Christmas list. Santa baby, the deed. To a platinum mine, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Santa baby, and fill my stocking with the duplex and check. Sign your X on the line, Santa baby, so hurry down the chimney tonight. Come and trim my Christmas tree with some decorations bought at Tiffany. I really do believe in you. Let's see if you believe in me. Santa baby, forgot to mention one little thing. The ring. I don't mean on the phone, Santa baby. So hurry down the chimney tonight.
Hurry up, Santa.
Just
not sure I meant to follow that, and if you look closely, I think you might see a tear in my eye. And I'm pretty sure that I'm not the only person who's sat in the audience this evening actually feeling immensely proud of our students, but also really enjoying the experience, albeit in one of these, which I never thought I'd ever enjoy singing behind a mask. We all sat in the audience this evening. That was just such a magical experience. So I'd never thought that if you'd told me 2 years ago, A, I'd be wearing one of these, B, I'd be singing in one, C, I'd be enjoying a concert at Chesham Grammar School with a hall that's a third full, I wouldn't have believed you. But I'm sure that I speak for everybody here when I say that was a truly, truly magical couple of hours. Music, of course, plays a central part in the life of our school, except it hasn't for the last 2 years. And this morning we had an assembly for Year 7, and we were treated to Jingle Bells. And I sat there thinking that how unusual the last 4 months of their experience has been, because normally when a child joins CGS, they're treated to music and the orchestra and our man choir, our choirs, as a matter of course in assemblies. And that was the first time they'd heard a musical piece being played since they joined the school in September. And of course, the Year 8s won't have heard anything either since they joined. So again, I've sat there this evening really, really enjoying the experience we've had tonight. And let's hope that it isn't very long before we get to do this all again. I know that this evening there are a huge number of people involved behind the scenes and obviously here who we'd like to thank. Mrs. Jashari, as always, who of course, I know she probably hates me saying this, but was sat here once herself as a CGS student. Sorry, Mr. Jashari. And of course, a number of other students, ex-students who are in the hall this evening. I think the fact they're so willing to come back, even in the current circumstances, is testament to the joy they have for the school and, of course, the joy they had when they were here themselves as musicians and as performers. So thank you very much. And you know that you are always a CGS student and you know you are always welcome back here, however old you may be. I can also see in the audience, in the orchestra, some of our Perrys. So again, thank you very much for giving up this evening to be here with us. And of course, Mr. Jashari, Mrs. Lewis, English Department, for whom without whom this evening simply would not have happened. Thank you very, very much. An immense privilege of being the head teacher here, but I have to say this has been the most joyous hour and a half of my life since March 2020, I think, and certainly this term. There have been so many difficult things to deal with that actually this has just made it all worthwhile, almost. And I know that in time-honoured tradition there are some of our Year 13s for whom this is their last Christmas in Words and Music who would like to say something now.
Obviously, this has been a really hard year for everyone with lockdown, year group bubbles. This is our first concert in nearly 2 years, and for us, our last Christmas in Words of Music.
The music department has been a massive part of our lives since we were in Year 7 and has always been incredibly supportive of us throughout our time here. And even beforehand, I remember when I was in Year 6 coming to the concert and Mrs. Lewis saying, "Where are you going to be next year?" and pointing at the violin section. I nodded, not realising I was signing away my free time for the next 7 years.
So yeah, we just want to say a massive, massive thank you to you both for doing basically all of this evening and everything you do for all of these amazing people behind us.
Yes, and just before we finish and have the last carol, Mrs. Lewis,
We'd like to make a formal apology for the amount of noise we make in choir. We're very sorry, and while we don't promise to stop, we are very, very sorry. We've bought you both something. I think Evie and Lauren are coming with it now, but thank you very much.
Polly, Amelia, you know you're welcome back every year, and we look forward to seeing you back with us next year. And of course, there were some students who left us last June, last year's year 13, who didn't get to have their own last Christmas and Words music, so you are particularly welcome. I can see Aaron there, and Isabel, yes, I look forward to catching up with you later. Okay, well, all that's left for me to do is to say thank you again. We are going to have a retiring collection for Cancer Research and Make-A-Wish, both of which are charities close to our heart. I wish you all a peaceful and a Merry Christmas, and O Come All Ye Faithful.